Okay, Noelia.
As you know, you've got 15 minutes to present. Mm-hmm. After your presentation, you have a seat and we'll ask you some questions. You can start.
Okay, good morning. I'm going to present about the implementation of audiovisual aids to foster EFL adult learners' willingness to communicate. So as an introduction, today with the development of globalization affecting many aspects of our lives, and with the availability of audiovisual aids, we can take many advantages from them to provide opportunities for learners and for teachers as well. Willingness to communicate is a complex and a key concept that is very important for learning a second language, and it may be influenced by many factors, which can be shown in the learner's behavior, in the lack of interest, or in the lack of participation, among others. Also, that's why audiovisual aids are present in this research, because those advantages we can take are very important to foster in some way this willingness to communicate. And as I could observe during the internship, the lessons were basic on worksheets and the coursebook. So the only use of audiovisual aids was the projection of the same worksheets on the screen. The context in which these researches were carried out was an English Advanced 2 course in Santo Tomas University. This was a group of EFL adult learners. And as I already mentioned, in the internship it was possible to observe that learners' lack of motivation to participate, as they didn't have much opportunities to initiate conversations or to share ideas. It was mainly giving their answers to what the teacher asked. And the lessons were basic on worksheets. And there were a few audiovisual materials. And as Mineduc states, the use of media appeals to the senses of the students and helps them to process information and create a context through which the different skills are integrated. This motivates them to participate actively in the task in the class, of the class, presents the language in a communicative context, and helps them to obtain information quickly. So a lot of research has been found about the effectiveness of audiovisual aids. For example, Juno, Sally, and John talks about the effectiveness of these materials in the presentation of the content, and also because students engage quickly in the activities and it's easier to understand those abstract ideas. According to Daniel, these type of materials are effective and interesting for learners. Carrasquillo says that audiovisual materials are a good option to promote motivation, because they are based in authentic speech in real situations, so they could have an approach to meaningful learning. On the other hand, Diaz says that there are possible barriers in the integration of these materials for teachers. Maduri says that these materials have a double effect, one positive, and the negative one has relation with if the material are not appropriately used, they could distract the learners. And according to Mineduc, teachers must be aware of technical problems and how to solve them. So there is an absence of studies related to audiovisual aids and willingness to communicate. But all this information has been very useful to prove the effectiveness of audiovisual aids, not only on willingness to communicate, but on motivation, anxiety, vocabulary, grammar, etc. So the purpose of this research is to determine if there was an improvement or if the audiovisual materials foster willingness to communicate, and also to provide opportunities to learners to communicate in real context and provide them with an environment where they could feel more relaxed. And the question of research is how many implementation of audiovisual aids foster willingness to communicate of Inglés Avanzado 2 learners in Santo Tomás University. So the general objective aim is to comprehend the effects that the implementation of audiovisual aids may have on a group of EFL adult children learners' willingness to communicate as externally observed. Two specific objectives are designed. The first one is to understand learners' willingness to communicate before the implementation of audiovisual aids, and the second one to observe if the implementation of audiovisual aids produce a change on learners' willingness to communicate. The research assumptions were that this kind of materials may produce an improvement in willingness to communicate, and they would feel more relaxed in a comfortable environment and provide opportunities to communicate among them with the teachers and avoid possible barriers that I'm going to call these external factors, such as the attitudinal ones, the personality ones, or the cognitive. There are four key concepts that are relevant for this research. The first one is English as a foreign language, that according these authors, agreeing that it's a context in which learners don't have opportunities to communicate in real context, and it doesn't play an essential role for cultural society. The second one, adult learners, according to Robles, Lemos, and Gonzalez, which refers to a set of characteristics which are adult learners are more mature, competent, experienced, in contrast with another type of learners. They use deep learning strategies and they present high levels of self-efficacy and engagement. The third one, audiovisual aids, according to the three authors, they are a set of computer-delivered materials such as images, videos, audios, and that it is characterized by the appealing of the different types of learners. And the last one, willingness to communicate, these offers refers to the intention and readiness to initiate a conversation and the predisposition to do it, and that willingness to communicate may be influenced by many factors, minor or major. The paradigm of this research is the critical one, as the intention is to produce an improvement on willingness to communicate. And as according to Cohen, Manon, and Morrison, its purpose is not merely to understand situations and phenomena, but to change them. The approach is the qualitative, as the data collection materials are interview, focus group, and observations. So they give the possible to capture more details of the behavior, the reactions, the impressions of the learners. So one of the key elements of collecting data in this way is to observe participants' behavior during their engagement in the activities. And the design is the actual research because it follows the four steps, which are plan, act, reflect, and observe and reflect. And because there is a situation which is intended to improve. So, according to Franklin, Waller, and Huhn, those involved in actual research generally want to solve some kind of day-to-day immediate problem. The steps for the methodological procedure are first, according to Mills, 2011, is to identify the main problem, where the research question arose. Through the collection of data, in the first period of observations, that before implementing this set of interventions, which is the step of designing the action plan, plus observations. And then afterward, the implementation of audiovisual aids are we're going to carry it out. And through this process, a set of observations arose about the effectiveness of audiovisual aids. And the last step is to reflect on this effectiveness. The subjects are, as already mentioned, is the English Advanced 2 in Santo Tomas University. They are integrated by approximately 13 students from the different programs and from a range of age from 21 to 45 years old. And according to Hernández Fernández Collao Batista, it was chosen the homogeneous sample because the subjects share the same characteristics. And they were selected according to what was observed during the preliminary observations, those who were more willing and less willing to communicate. So the research materials are first an interview applied to two participants and with six questions. The second is a set of four interviews applied to the whole class. The third one, a set of observations also applied to the whole class. And the last one, a focus group applied to four participants and which contains four questions. The steps of the data analysis are first it's basic on organizing, categorizing, and coding. So the first step is organize the information into codes from the preliminary observations where the research question was identified. Then transcribe the information from the interview and organize it into codes. Then the observation from the action plan, the information from this process is organized into codes. Then the information gathered through the focus group is were transcribed and organized into codes. And lastly, the triangulation matrix, which are two, one from the interview and observations, and the next one from the focus group and observations. The credibility of this research is based on that the data collection materials give me the possibility to observe students in their natural environment without any intervention from the researcher. And this information could be interpreted according to what was observed during this whole process. Triangulation to assure validity, credibility, and confirmability, and also to support those witnesses that the other data collection materials has. And transferability, this is based on that the detailed description of learners' behavior, learners' perspective, and how this can be applied to another context. And debatability, about how this research could be applied in another context, but it could have another type of results, although it may be similar to the ones obtained in this one. And the critical intelligence has relation with how the researcher has identified a problem and designed a plan to act upon it. The findings, in the first period of observations, the two main concepts that emerged were nominating and prompting. An example of nominating is, as there wasn't much participation in the activity, the teacher starts nominating students to give the answers. The interview. An example of this question is, en la clase de inglés, ¿qué tan dispuesto estarías a hablar frente a tus compañeros en inglés y por qué? The evidence says that depende porque igual me da vergüenza y adelante de todo, ir adelante de todos que me estén mirando y si no hace nada mis compañeros sí, sería peor. Pero depende de la actividad también porque si es entre dos compañeros ya bien, es más fácil. So the purpose of the interviews The questions are focused on the context and the type of interlocutor with which learners may feel more willing to communicate. This is the interview matrix where goals such as nervousness, shyness, fear of mockery, interaction patterns, and willingness arose. And this is our some excerpts from the matrix. In the action plan with the four interventions plus the observations, goals such as willingness to communicate, audiovisual aids, motivation, nominating, and prompting emerge. And this is another excerpt from the from these examples. For example, audiovisual aids and willingness to communicate. The focus group, which aims to gather information about the effectiveness and the points of view that learners have during the implementation of audiovisual aids in the lessons. For example, a question is, ¿te sentiste motivado a comunicarte en inglés? And then it says, sí, me motivó a participar a hablar más. Igual cuando hicimos actividades, estaba más interesado en saber la respuesta, a saber cómo terminar las actividades. Esas veces que hicimos las competencias con los juegos o los diálogos. And this is the matrix for the focus group. And goals such as willingness, self-confidence, audiovisual aids, motivation, and interaction patterns emerge. And these are some examples of two of these goals. And the triangulation matrix. The first one, from the interview and observations, goals such as categories such as external factors, motivation for communication, willingness to communicate, and audiovisual aids. And in the second one, between the focus group and observations, external factors, influence of audiovisual aids on willingness to communicate, and influence of interaction patterns on willingness to communicate. The data collection materials were based on the operationalization of willingness to communicate based on the pyramid model of McIntyre, which describe a set of factors that may influence willingness to communicate. These factors may be categorized into behavioral intentions, situated antecedent, motivation and propensities, affective cognitive context, and social and individual context. So finally, the results were organized into under six categories. The first one, audiovisual aids, the results show that learners felt more motivated to participate, that audiovisual aids has a positive effect, not only in creating a positive environment, but in the way they understand the content. And this produced a self-confidence because as they understand the content, it was easier to show what they understand. Willingness to communicate, this was before the implementation of the audiovisual aids, and it has relationship with the lack of encouragement from the teacher. Some external factors such as mocking or embarrassment, shyness, that affect that willingness to communicate. External factors that, for example, the type of context or the type of interlocutors, shyness, nervous environment, lack of self-confidence affect the willingness to communicate. For example, the type of context between the teacher or friends or the interlocutors like friends or strangers. Motivation for communicating, that they felt that they had more opportunities to communicate, they felt more relaxed, and those external factors were diminished in some way. The influence of interaction patterns on willingness to communicate was a plus for this research because it wasn't considered as an external factor, but it was proved that they felt more secure when they share or they have to talk with classmates that they know or they consider their friends or small groups. And the influence of audiovisual aids on willingness to communicate, which this type of materials has created a comfortable environment that motivation has been improved and self-confidence that they felt more secure to express or initiate conversations. And this was a process in which they started from less to more. So the question, how may the implementation presentation about the video lays foster willingness to communicate of English and Salvador learners in Santo Tomas University was fully answered because it was a group that that indeed these materials has fostered in some way the willingness to communicate, and also because it has proved that there are a lot of factors that affect willingness to communicate, apart from those that were considered. And the assumptions that were proved also, and for and consequence, the two specific objectives. As a conclusion, it was possible to have a better comprehension of the concept of willingness to communicate and audiovisual aids, as they are more complex than expected. That the factors of the BARIC model are just a few ones that are always appear more, and the advantages of the of this type of materials are more than expected, because it doesn't just influence willingness to communicate, but the content, the context, and their motivation. So for this reason, there are more existing factors. The self-confidence was a common factor among the answers that the learners gave, because they felt more confidence with the audiovisual aids and with these interaction patterns. As it was shown, the friendship was a plus for willingness to communicate, for them to feel more comfortable. Well, the limitations are the willingness to communicate or paralyzation. It was very complex and very difficult for me to put into practice the data collection materials according to this concept. So it has a lot of involvement that I wasn't, that I hadn't considered. But also the lack of time for carrying out the data collection materials and the analysis. The student's agenda, that it wasn't compatible with mine, and the Hawthorne effects, that it was avoided through the relationship that I had with the students during this period of interventions. And the contributions and the influence that audiovisual has on learners' performances, on the way they speak English, they learn English, and for the lesson planning, because they have a lot of advantages that teachers could have from them. To provide a meaningful learning, and for the content that it makes easier for learners to understand. The metacognitive analysis, well, as the teacher's role, as I could experience, it has to be an active role involved in each process and identify each necessity that the students may have, and adapt to it to these necessities. It could be a guide to promote, to be reflective, etc. The stress, I think that is rapport, because I created a very good relationship with the students. I think that they could trust me about what they thought about my lessons, what were my weaknesses. So the relationship between us was very good, and it helped to comfort environment. And the weaknesses are explaining, because as the feedback from the tutor was very common, that she said that explaining was one of my weaknesses, because when I'm on the front of the students, I got very nervous, and I got confused, and I confused learners. And the challenges are the teacher's roles, that I have to be aware of each necessity that the students have and adapt those roles to this necessity.